Hello, and welcome again to our Windows 7 Beginner to Advanced Video Training Series. Chapter 2, Lesson 1, Microsoft Wordpad, Part 4. In our fourth part of Wordpad series, today we will first talk about font colors, and then bullets and numbering feature. In Wordpad, bullet points and numbering can be used to make your lists easy to read and more visually attractive. Bullet points are kind of symbols, like dots, that can be placed before a line to provide importance to a line. In this exercise, I already have two documents on the screen. The first document is totally unformatted. And then we have a formatted version of the same document with font colors, bold, italics, and bullets and numbering. You can see that an unformatted document is not making a good impact on the reader, whereas a properly formatted document is easy to read and also looks nice visually. As you can see that a little bit formatting can make your document more attractive. So, here we will apply some basic formatting options on our unformatted version of the document, along with other formatting commands, which we had covered in our previous exercise. We will also learn how to use font colors, and bullets and numbering. There are two ways to apply bullets and numbering to your lists. The first method is to type the list and later apply the bullets or numbering, or you can have numbers or bullets before you start typing the list. It is up to you that which method you would like to choose. This is really an easy task. Just select your list and click on the bullets button. You can also change the position of the bullets and list by clicking on the increase indent button. By using indents, you can make any line in the list as a subpoint or vice versa. You can also apply different style of numbering for your subheadings. You can remove bullets or numbering from particular lines just by selecting the text, and then clicking on the same button again. You can change the style of numbering as many times you want. You can also change numbering to bullets, and bullets to numbering, whenever required. Unfortunately, Wordpad has only one style of bullets, whereas in other word processors, you have different styles of bullets available. While working with your lists, you can also adjust the indents manually by moving the left indent to desired location. When you apply numbering to a list, Wordpad will try to adjust the series of numbers, but if you are trying to apply numbering on a list which has subheadings, then your list series can broke or mismatch. You can also apply different colors on your text. Just select your text and choose an appropriate color from text color drop-down menu. Now, let's quickly format this document, so you may have an idea of using Wordpad features more efficiently. Stay tuned with me, as it is going to take just 1 minute. If you want to select a complete line, just move your mouse pointer in front of the line, and when your mouse pointer has a shape of an arrow, then left click from your mouse, Wordpad will automatically select the entire line. If something goes wrong during selection or formatting, then click on the undo button to revert your current changes. Do note down that you can revert back to many steps you have performed recently by using undo command repeatedly. After completing the formatting, let's have a look on the preview of this document. As you can see in the preview window, the Next Page button is now active. That means your document now has more than one page. If you click this button, then you can notice that our content has expanded on two pages, whereas I want to print them on a single page. To make the contents fit on one page, let's first click on Two Pages button, so we can see the preview of both pages, side by side. To adjust the contents, we can perform many steps. But first we will look into the page settings by clicking on Page Setup button. Here you can see that our paper size is correct, which is A4, and I am going to take print out of this document on A4 size sheet. But I can reduce the top and bottom margins of the page, as I do not want to have so much space on both sides. So I set them to 0.25 inches for both top and bottom margin. I am also going to uncheck print page numbers, because I don't want page numbers in my printout. After applying the changes, you can see that now we have more lines on our first page, but the contents are still expanding on two pages. So, what else I can do is that I can reduce the spacing between paragraphs. In our current document, WordPad is assuming each line is a separate paragraph, because we have broken every line by pressing the Enter key. So, to select the entire document, I click on Select All button, and this feature will select the entire text of your document, in just one click. Now, we click on Line Spacing button, and uncheck the Add 10 Point Spacing after paragraphs. Let's see the preview again, and now we have our entire contents fitted on one page. But, still the top and bottom margins are not perfect. From the top of page, we have less spacing, whereas in bottom side of the page we have more blank space. To correct this, I click on Page Setup button again, and this time I only increase the top margin to 1 inch. And now we have our document in perfect shape. There is some important information, which you should note down. As you can see that my current measurement style is inches. This default setting for measurement unit depends on region settings, which is set during the installation of Windows. However, you can change the measurement style by clicking on View tab, and choose an appropriate style that suits to you and your documents. Two most popular styles are inches and centimeter. As I change measurement style from inches to centimeters, you can immediately notice the changes in the ruler bar. Do note down that the measurement style will then apply everywhere in the application, where you have to give the measurement specifications. You can see the changed style of units in the margins of page setup and paragraph settings. As I told you before, you can also have bullets and numbering before you start typing your contents. Click the drop-down arrow from Start a List button, and choose either you want bullets or numbering. As you will start typing your list, the bullets or numbering will automatically start increasing. When you want to stop, just press an extra Enter, and your list will stop. In our lesson 3, of chapter 1, Notepad Full Overview, I had described in depth about using cut, copy and paste command. I had also explained that how you can use find and replace command in your documents. Let's have a quick overview of these commands again. The cut and paste commands can be used to shift the contents from one place to another. To cut a piece of information, first you have to select that particular contents that you wish to move. Then click the Cut button from Clipboard section. Clipboard will then save this information in the memory. Clipboard is a temporary storage application in Windows 7, which saves the cut or copied information in the memory, so later you can paste that information when required. Now, move to the desired location and click the Paste button. In the same manner, you can use the Copy command to duplicate contents. Just select the contents you wish to copy, and click the Copy button. Now, move to the desired location and click the Paste button. Your contents will be duplicated. You can also cut or copy the contents from one document to another document, or from one application to another. When working in long documents, consisting of many pages, then find and replace are most useful commands to search and replace contents. You can easily find a piece of information in your long documents. Click the Find button, and type the text you wish to find in your document. And then click Find Next button. In a matter of second, Wordpad will search your entire document for specific text, and will move your position to specific location, in the background. If this is what you were finding, then click the Cancel button, or if you wish to continue your search, then click Find Next button again. You can also filter your search by making a check mark on Match Whole Word Only. For instance, I want to find Develop Word in my document. As I continue my search, you can see that Wordpad is finding Develop Word inside other words like Development and Developed. If you wish to filter your search only to the exact keywords, then make a check mark on Match Whole Word Only. Now, Wordpad will only look up for Develop Word alone. You can also make your search case sensitive. Means, Wordpad will match the exact case of the characters that you have typed in Find What box. For instance, this time I find Develop with the first letter D as capital. Now Wordpad is ignoring all other similar words, but finding only the case sensitive matched word. Do remember that if you are making continuous searches for different words, then do not forget to move your cursor position to the top of document every time you made a search. You can use replace command to change a set of words at once, without manually editing each of them. For instance, I want to change era word in my document to time, so what I do is to type era in find what box, and time in replace with box. I am also checking both options match whole word only, and match case. That means, I want Wordpad to find era word alone and only find era, which have E, in capital. First of all, I click on Find Next button to see what Wordpad finds. So, if I want to change that specific word, then I will click Replace button. If you are sure about your changes, then you can also change all the similar words at once, by clicking on Replace All button. If something goes wrong, then use Undo command to revert back your changes. Here I have another document, in which I want to highlight the headings. For this, I can use Text Highlight Color command. Just select your heading, and click on appropriate color you want to highlight with. If you decide to choose black as a background color, then you can have white as your text color. You can also extend the range of highlight by adding some additional spaces or tabs in the line. With this way, if you will apply highlight command, then Wordpad will automatically add highlight color to the blank space as well. When you need to type a math like equations, then you can use subscript and superscript commands. But don't think of typing a mathematics question paper. For instance, I want to make third as an ordinal word, then what I have to do is to select only R and D, and click on superscript button. This will change it to ordinal style number. I also want to change the 1.5 year in the last line of this document in fraction style. Here, see how you can do this? First, select 1 from 1/2 and then click on superscript. Then select 2 from 1/2 and click on subscript. This will make it look like fraction style numbers. It is not perfect, but still better than simple format. You can remove highlight by selecting your text, and then click on None from Highlight drop-down menu. But don't forget to change your text color. You can also turn off subscript and superscript by selecting the text and clicking on the same buttons again. In our next and final chapter of Wordpad, we will learn how to insert picture, drawings, and objects. We will also learn that, how you can work faster using keyboard shortcut keys. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.